once again, Lord, you are here to see how the world that we are getting on. I make my report. Your stars, planets, galaxies are not my cup of tea. The self-inflicted woes of men are all that interest me. Give me the little gods of this world in just the same situation as on the first day of creation. Sir, would life on Earth be quite so vile had you not given him that glimmer of light which he calls reason?
Is this all you have to say? Nothing but complaints every day? Does nothing please you down on Earth?
To tell the truth, sir, things go from bad to worse. The torments of mankind move even me to pity, not to plague humanity.
You know my servant, Faustus?
The doctor?
Yes?
The doctor! The explorer, cartographer, merchant, missionary, scholar, slaver.
Yes.
He is still there. After all these years, he sticks it out in his hotel room at the furthest edge of a far-out colony. Unable to leave, unable to stay, weighted down with all his books. And all the books about him, driven by his obsessions, he's hurled up into spheres where he himself half knows how mad he is. But still the poor man goes on hankering after heaven's brightest star and craving earthly joys of every kind.
He serves me still uncomprehendingly, but I shall lead him soon toward the light. The gardener knows by looking at the tree what flowers and fruit lie ripening out of sight.
Sir, we all know you like your game of dice. What do you bet you do not lose his soul? Provided, of course, you give me leave to lead him down to hell to whichever route I choose.
Done. While he is still on Earth and still alive, try whatever springs to mind. Men make mistakes till they cease to strive.
Thanks for that, sir. I never much liked people once they're dead. I prefer the full pink bloom of youth. To me, a corpse is not a welcome guest. Cat and mouse is the game I play best.
But if things do not go quite as you had planned, admit with shame that among those souls you claim are some that cannot be moved even by you. From the good they dimly, stubbornly pursue.
I like to hear the old man, now and then, and always take care not to break with him. He's very decent, quite the gentleman, letting poor devils like me speak with him.
Thank you. philosophy behind me. Law and medicine too. And to my cost, theology. All studied, grimly sweated through, and here I sit, as big a fool as when I first attended school. True, I surpass the dull incompetence, doctors, pastors, and masters, and to the rest, for whom there is no bliss by ignorance. But this preeminence I now detest. All my laborious studies only show that nothing is the most we ever know. Scruples I've laid aside, doubt as well. I have no fear of devil or hell. This is what robs me of all delight. I cannot boast that what I know is right. I cannot boast my teachings will ever find a way to improve or convert mankind. Doomed souls within me wrestle for possession, and neither will surrender to his brother. One is of the senses, sensual, slaking his appetites like an animal. The other strives for purity of mind, to leave the world and its works behind. If there are spirits listening in the air, descend now from your golden stratosphere. Carry me off to new life, anywhere.
He holds in highest veneration. He runs with compulsion to what he shrinks from in revulsion. The papers he crumbles into the waste paper basket are for him what a cadaver is to a casket.
What are you grinning at, you hollow skull? Because your brain, like mine, once sought the spark of truth, but fell victim to mere dull confusion. And was swallowed in the dark.
As for me, he's also loyal servant, constant to the breadth of his travels. For him, I have broken necks and snapped backs, all the while suffering his every insult. For his every fall, I've been a cushion. I've been thrown like dice in someone else's gamble on paradise.
Here I am, in the middle of the wave. Too young to be without desires, too old to be content to throw my time away. What comfort can the mortal world still hold? I wake each morning with a start of pain, knowing that by the time each day is done, I shall be forced to acknowledge once again not one desire has been fulfilled. Not one! And once again, as night descends and I lie staring on my bed, the hell that is inside me sends terrible dreams to fill my head. Deep in my soul, Dawn stirs the springs, but cannot move external things. Existence has become a mere dead weight. Would death could free me from the life I hate.